can have an answer for. Davis in two games against Northwestern this season, 29 points and 13 rebounds.
Well, Davis is, as I said, was playing his best basketball game against Wisconsin as the Spartans were trying to nail down a Big Ten championship, or at least a share of it. Leg cramps, he had to go out. The 10 days off, I think, helps him. They need him back and healthy.
We also have in this game the Big Ten Coach of the Year for 2004, Bill Carmody, in his fourth season at Northwestern. The Wildcats are 14-14, and the underlying factor for this game tonight, Greg, is they must win to become eligible for the postseason. A loss takes them out of everything, including the NIT.
You know, and that's really unfortunate because they have had an incredible year. Northwestern has defeated 8 Big Ten schools during the course of this season. I don't know that they've done that in any year prior, certainly not recently.
Ben, you'd have to go back to the early to mid-70s for the last time Northwestern had that many conference wins. Meanwhile, one of the most decorated coaches in the country, and there he is right there between the players, Coach Tom Izzo, his 9th year, has led Michigan State to 1 national title, 4 regular season Big Ten championships, 2 postseason titles. In the 7 years now of this tournament, Michigan State is the only school to win 2 Big Ten postseason tournaments.
You know, Michigan State, too, is the only team since this tournament started to not have to play on Thursday.
That's right.
They've always been a 5 seed or better, avoiding that situation where you have to win 4 to win it all.
There's a look at Tim Young. Boy, what a ball game yesterday for this Northwestern squad. They set a tournament record with 22 steals. Young had 8 of them. He played 40 minutes. But I will tell you this, to Tim Young, TJ Parker, and Mohammed Ashad all played 40 minutes. Vedran Bakusic played 38, and Dov Ordoancic 36 minutes. Bill Carmody played 6 players yesterday.
Right, you know, and that's why a lot of people are not as enthusiastic about Northwestern's chances of pulling an upset in this tournament because they don't have the depth, and they would have to win 4 in 4 days.
It'll be Davis and Mohammed Ashad on the tip. Ashad and Card. And Davis able to control. Anderson quickly to Hill. The lob for Torbert, and he converts in spectacular fashion. What a recovery by Torbert. That thing was nowhere close to going in.
That was a situation where Michigan State knew it could get the jump ball, so they decided to attack off that jump ball and run what they call the goat.
And boy, did they go.
They went.
Here's to Tim Young against Kelvin Torbert. Good matchup there. Torbert, an excellent defensive player. Mohammed Ashad. What Michigan State did very well last month up in East Lansing was take away the back cuts that are so prevalent in this Princeton offense.
Northwestern forces you to have to play long stretches of defense.
Young beats the shot clock for 3.
Man, if Jatim Young can knock that down, then Michigan State may be in trouble.
How about a start to this one, huh? Can you believe it?
Where do we go from here?
Yeah, well, I hate to say it. I don't want to drive our audience away after all. Northwestern lost 2 games this season, but played Michigan State tough both games. Tom Izzo a little bit worried about this game, said that they spent most of their last 10 days working on Northwestern once they knew Northwestern would be their opponent. They spent most of their time working on Northwestern, not because they thought the Wildcats necessarily would get in, but because of the unorthodox offense. Nice move right there by Chris Hill.
That was a terrific move by Chris Hill. That pump fake, and his pump fake is very convincing because you have to go up on him and close out.
Duancic bumped by Davis. First personal foul of the game.
Foul charge to number 40.
It didn't take long for these two teams to get on the board.
4 players touched the ball in about 2 seconds right there. That was pretty.
Northwestern running some offense now.
Michigan State planning zone right now.
Yeah.
And Northwestern opened in a zone. So you may see a lot of zone from these two teams during the course of this game. Michigan State playing the zone, hoping to impede some of the back cutting that Northwestern will give you.
Good spacing on this set so far. To Tim Young looking 12 to go on the shot clock now. Remember, Young got that shot off just in time to beat the shot clock a few moments ago. Down to 7, and then Torbert bails them out with a foul. As he fouls Dewanchich.
Again, if you're Michigan State, you must stay defensively sound for maybe the entire shot clock, 35 seconds. The moment you break down is when Northwestern is able to hit you with that back door, or they'll find the open man for a three-point shot.
And Greg, when forced into the half court, Northwestern is very content to run that shot clock under 10 every time if they have to.
Every time.
So you're right, it does demand a little bit more defensively, especially if you're in a man-to-man, but discipline if you're in a zone. Vukušić and a circus shot across the lane.
Well, Northwestern in their first two possessions, they attack from the outside and get a three, go inside and get a two. That shows balance.
Brown got bumped in the lane, and the freshman Shannon Brown will go to the line.
You know, when you talk about Michigan State getting the 10 days off, not only were they able to get Paul Davis healthy, not only were they able to work on Northwestern's half-court offense, you know, Wayne, they were able to work on their own psyche because they were dealt a very tough blow, losing to Wisconsin at home in a game that could have won them a share of the Big Ten title.
This has been a season of adversity for Michigan State in many respects. 6-7 off one of the toughest, the toughest non-conference campaign of the season, of anybody's basketball season this year.
Maybe at any time ever.
I mean, they played everybody from Duke on down, Kentucky, go on down the road.
And did not play a lot of those games in the Breslin Center.
No, they played Kentucky at Ford Field before one of the biggest crowds ever to see a college basketball game. Parker in the lane, able to steer out of there. He got bopped in the nose, no foul. 10 to go.
Northwestern also has been taking very good care of the basketball up late.
Young with 5 to go, down to 3. Young had it knocked away, gets it back, forces the shot, nearly made that. With the shot clock buzzer sounding. Shannon Brown, Michigan State quickly to the offense, but equally as quick was Northwestern in setting up defensively. Vukušić blocked, didn't get a call. Hill, here's Torbert. Out of the corner for 3, Brown. Torbert the rebound, and then let it go out of bounds. Thought he had DeAndreas on the wing.
Now, Northwestern can play their zone. They're sound in that zone. But what they must do is rebound out of that zone. At times when you're in a zone, you don't know who exactly to block out. You're searching for people when the shot goes up. It's important that they put a body on people and not allow Michigan State to own the offensive glass.
To Tim Young, open look. Ring it up.
Boy, he looks ready to play, doesn't he?
Well, again, here's a great senior. Can smell the finish line of his career. He wants to go out in style. Anderson for 3, answers right back for Michigan State. Good start scoring wise to this one. 4 minutes gone by.
Basketball, Allen Anderson.
Parker on the drive on Andreas. Jason Andreas, the last remaining member of the Final Four, the national championship team of Michigan State. Hill, and he loves that spot on the floor.
He's the only one out there, Jason Andreas, that can tell us what it's like, huh?
Yeah.
What it's like to win it all.
Well, you could tell us.
I said
you
on the floor. I said on the floor.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but you've got a microphone in front of you. You better tell our audience. The shot, oh, a deep three, long carom, and Northwestern remains on the offense. Parker picks it off.
When Michigan State gives up an offensive rebound, it just means they're going to play a minute of defense more often than not.
There's the back cut to Jatim Young. Beautiful feed from Vukušić. Jatim Young with 8 points. Right back, Michigan State. Anderson clears. Hill for 3. Ring it up.
Michigan State's quick hitting team. When you have success offensively, if you're Northwestern, you got to get back very quickly. You can't celebrate. You got to get back and match up because Michigan State will push it up the floor after a made field goal by the opponent.
Good reception inside. Vukušić lost it on the strip down low. First turnover, Northwestern. Anderson clears to Shannon Brown.
Notice Michigan State really hasn't established anything inside. It's all been perimeter.
Andreas out high. Davis, an early substitute. Andreas for Davis in this game. Kind of a curious substitution. Here's the steal by Muhammad Ashad and a foul on Kelvin Torbert. And on Torbert, it's his second personal foul. Third on the team. Timeout on the floor. Nothing has come easy for Northwestern. To Tim Young on the reverse. And then Chris Hill on the wing for three. Good start offensively for both sides.
The following is performed by trained professionals. Do not try this at home. You'll laugh. You'll cringe. You'll wonder how they get insurance. You'll laugh till it hurts. Them. The 5 o'clock funnies on Indiana's WB4.
Wow, that hurts.
Other burgers are circular or rectangular, but the steak burger is spatular.
Till people give you their order, I can't cook their order to order.
Right. People order, then I order you to cook the order to order.
In that order.
Exactly.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious. The sippable sundae.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
What we've discovered in treating the most critical cases has led to breakthroughs in the most common. So, while you may only be with us a short time, each visit reflects nearly 100 years of caring for the people of Central Indiana. Methodist Hospital. The difference is our experience.
Chevy Impala. A responsive performer that never forgets it's a mid-size sedan. And now through March 31st, don't forget you can still leave your checkbook at home. GM employees who are qualified lessees can lease an Impala sedan for $199 a month with zero due at signing. Tax, title, and license extra. Residency restrictions apply. Call for important lease details. Chevy Impala. Turn the key. Start a revolution. See your Central Indiana Chevy dealer today.
Michigan State leading by two, and Greg Kelser with almost 6 minutes gone by this first half. How about some keys?
Well, first of all, for Northwestern, you want to dictate the tempo. That means you need to utilize that shot clock. It's a big part of your game, and if it's going to be a full-court game, you decide when. Michigan State needs to avoid unforced turnovers. Keep this in mind. Northwestern led the conference in turnover margin, a plus five. They don't turn it over much. They will force some. Michigan State needs to take care of it.
And Greg, to embellish your keys, 8 trips down the floor offensively for Tim Young and company. 3 times they've run the clock under 10 seconds, and they've scored on 2 of those trips. Michigan State in the early going, 2 turnovers. Northwestern resumes offensively, down by 2. Michigan State showing that zone. Here's on the drive to Tim Young, forces it. Offensive foul, warded off with the off arm. His first foul of the game.
You see the strength of Tim Young, but you see the defensive footwork of Allen Anderson to get himself in position. He stayed in front of Tim Young the entire time, and therefore that was an easy call for the official. That was sound defense by Allen Anderson.
Northwestern did a lot of tramping yesterday in their victory over Purdue, and Tim Young triggered it loose. Here's Seacamp. 3 turnovers now.
That's one of those unforced errors we talked about Michigan State needing to avoid.
Vukušić squares up, nicely done. His second field goal of the game. He's got 4.
I like Vukušić. I mean, he's able to put the ball on the floor and create opportunities.
Maurice Ager had a career game against Northwestern in Evanston. Missed his first shot there.
Yeah, he had that career game all in the second half.
Dewanchich down low, knocked out of bounds by Hill. Michigan State appears to be fronting the post, Greg, and then filling a guard to the backside to knock it loose.
Yeah, trying to stay just as active as possible, give help on the post, and not allow Northwestern to get too comfortable or too strong inside.
Evan Seacamp with the ball right now. Missed the last 5 games of a season after sustaining a concussion against Penn State. He was wiped out on a screen by Jan Yagla. Maybe the hardest hit, and as the Penn State people might say, maybe the only hit Yagla delivered all year. Bad pass inside, stolen away by Davis. Anderson on the move. Parker back quickly on defense. Andreas to Davis, right through the wickets and out of bounds.
Another unforced error against Penn State. It was Northwestern getting, in the first half alone, 17 steals, forcing 20 turnovers. Michigan State, they cannot allow that to happen. That will keep Northwestern in this game.
Parker with a quick back cut, and they throw it away. Dewanchich, who delivers that bounce pass beautifully. A little bit too quick on the trigger there. Bill Carmody felt that maybe his man was held down low. I'm not sure what he was arguing with there with Donnie Gray. Now again, they've got guard pressure in the backcourt, Greg, and something that triggered a lot of turnovers in that victory yesterday over Penn State. And there's another steal. Jatim Young from behind again.
It's incredible. This is a very active Northwestern team.
Seacat, difficult shot. Young in among the trees, knocked out of bounds by Michigan State.
And it's an active Northwestern team that's playing with a lot of confidence. You know, Wayne, we saw what may have been the turning point for this Wildcat team when they got crushed at Michigan early in the Big Ten season, then went to Iowa and beat Iowa handily.
Yep.
Followed that up with the win at home against Illinois. I think right then they knew that they could compete against anybody in this conference.
Michigan State appears to be zoning the out-of-bounds play here. T.J. Parker has struggled with his shot this season. Dewanchich moved his pivot foot. Unforced error right there. Michigan State gets it back. Bill Carmody and company in a dogfight in the first 9 minutes of the game.
Used to be really good grass control. Came at a cost to the health of your corn. But that was before Option Herbicide. It's the first post-emerge grass herbicide with a built-in safener. Option gets all your major grasses and allows you to use higher caliber tank mixes. So you can also get your broadleaves, all without worrying about crop safety. Option, grass control that puts you in control.
Susan, I'm Frank's friend, Steve.
Of course you are.
Nice to meet you.
Come on in. Dinner's almost ready.
Oh, I thought we were going out. I made reservations.
Oh, no. I made lasagna. Oh, don't worry. I used soy cheese because I know that you're lactose intolerant.
Okay.
Oh, gosh, try this on.
Wow, you made this for me?
Yeah, I learned how to knit online. It's really no big deal. And these, and this. Okay, let's go meet my parents.
Special treatment. Bad idea for blind dates? Good idea for online trading. Ameritrade Apex is our premier active trading program. Get special benefits like the latest trading tools, access to exclusive webcasts, and discounts on research products.
Hi, Steve.
Sign up now and get $100 if you qualify for Apex, plus 25 commission-free internet equity trades. Go to ameritrade.com/apex/ or call 866-368-4610.
Beautiful Indianapolis, Indiana, Conseco Fieldhouse. A new building, but it feels like tradition. Northwestern for the second day. And, of course, a large contingent of Spartans down to Indianapolis from East Lansing. Coaches working and Sparty working it hard here in this final quarterfinal game of day two of the Big Ten tournament. We're tied at 12 apiece. The option stance splash. Early shooting, Gregory, very good for both sides, but both teams a little bit careless. 10 turnovers between them, 5
exactly.
Apiece. Each team has turned it over 3 times on its last 3 possessions. Again, Northwestern with that pressure in the backcourt. Maurice Ager able to get it across. Allen Anderson, Chris Hill.
Michigan State needs to figure out a way to get the ball inside because it's Paul Davis inside that needs to get active in this game. Hasn't had many touches at all.
Davis, and Matt Trannan. Trannan's a wide receiver on the football squad, but he's a bona fide basketball talent as well. He's trying to post up inside. Davis on the weak side against Fakusic.
Number 40.
That was a fine pass inside and a good catch by Davis. He needs to touch the basketball. He's a guy that can give Northwestern all kinds of problems inside because you can get him in foul trouble, and then you wear down and test the Northwestern depth.
All five starters have scored for Michigan State. That broke a slump of 327, but they had not scored from the field. Parker answers for three.
Yeah, if you can get Parker scoring, that's a big plus for Northwestern because he's struggled with his shot at times this year.
And again, right back, Hill gets an open look. Bring it up for three.
That's the second time that Northwestern has given Hill a wide open shot after they made a basket. You've got to locate him, especially when the ball is coming down the floor.
It's quite obvious State wants to force the issue whenever it can.
They really are trying, aren't they?
10 lead changes in this first half so far. Fakusic off with that shot, but it was last touched by Hill. Spartans by two, nearing the halfway point of this first half. Fakusic to Jatim Young. Trannan the rebound. Trannan, Paul Davis, off the block, wouldn't stay down. Maurice Ager, no, but a foul. Vukušić tied him up.
Again, the offensive rebounding used to be an absolute hallmark of Tom Izzo's teams. Now, this team this year, because of a lack of really big bodies, has not been able to beat that type of offensive rebounding team. But at times, if you don't block Michigan State off, they can still hurt you on the offensive window, and Northwestern has to understand that.
Michigan State plus 1.6 rebounding margin. That ranked eighth in the league, but they were better in league games. They were third in the league in rebounding margin, a plus three in league games. Maurice Ager makes good on his first to the line, his first point of the game.
You talked about the career game he had against Northwestern in Evanston. Well, 24 points, Wayne, but 22 in the second half.
Yep. Really came out of the second half. Fakusic blocks out on the rebound. 3-point lead, Michigan State. Dwancic, excellent passer. Young gets baseline, beat Ager to the baseline, and Maurice fouled him on the bump. His first, four on the team.
Well, Jatim Young able to catch and then accelerate from a standstill that time, putting a lot of pressure on the defender. He is so good.
He really is. It has been wonderful to watch him play for 4 years. A steal by Hill on the inbounds. Oh, nice speed, Ager. On the break, they beat Northwestern down the floor.
That's what Northwestern doesn't want to allow. That's the tempo that Michigan State wants to establish.
Biggest lead of the night for either team. Fakusic for three, not that time. Davis the rebound. Bograk is in for the first time tonight. Ball knocked out of bounds, and last touch by Muhammad Ashad. It'll belong to Michigan State. Watch the Spartans, good as it gets in transition.
Well, this is when they're playing their best. When they can get it up the floor before you're set and get easy opportunities. There's Maurice Ager on the finish. And Northwestern knows it's got to get back and do a better job than that.
Northwestern sets it up defensively, man-to-man it appears. Trannan picked up by Fakusic. Davis in the corner, bring it up for three. Maurice Ager, look out. 6 points off the bench for Ager. Knocked out of bounds, it'll belong to Northwestern.
Keep in mind now, if you're Northwestern, got to manage your deficit. You are not a team that can come back from huge deficits. So you need a basket here kind of calm this thing down and get these Michigan State fans back on their seats.
Michigan State, Greg, 8 of 12 from the field, 4 of 7 from the arc. Sizzling 67%. Young, Dewanchich, Vukušić for 3.
That was a very necessary basket by Vukušić. Don't want to have to fight from a deep hole if you're Northwestern.
Especially after having played yesterday.
Yep.
Davis, earlier this year, Tom Izzo wanted everything run through Paul Davis.
Michigan State, so far tonight, when they take care of the basketball, they're getting quality shots.
Ager, ring it! Again!
Wow.
9 for Maurice Ager.
They are going to force Northwestern to have to come out of the zone and guard because they're not stretching themselves out on the perimeter, and Michigan State continues to get uncontested looks.
Greg, I'll tell you something. Vukušić, good back cut there. Got Davis up on his back, and he'll go to the line. Paul Davis pick up his second personal foul. That's 5 on the team. I believe in 3 things, and I'll tell you when we come back. But Maurice Ager is heating it up, and one of the things I believe in are certain courses for certain horses. Maurice Ager is lighting up Northwestern again.
On the WB Monday, a life once perfect begins to unravel.
What happened? Sarah left me.
Seventh Heaven. Then, critics are calling Everwood the best show on television.
Are you sleeping with her? Answer me!
Everwood, after Seventh Heaven.
Monday, night at 8.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
You make me feel so young. Make home improvement so much fun. And every time I see your rates, I know I'll make my space look great. Fifth Third Equity Flex Lines low rates will make your space sing. 'Cause you make my space feel fun. Working hard to be the only bank you'll ever need.
With the world's hottest moto athletes. THQ World Supercross GP. Credit seats are just $10. To see prodigy James Stewart race for the first time ever in the RCA Dome. Just $10. For superstars Reed, Wyndham, hometown hero LaRocco, and more. Just $10. For adrenaline pumping racing. 1-800-SAFE-AUTO brings you THQ AMA Supercross Series. Brought to you by Subway, Eat Fresh, and Max Pitts Yamaha in Peru. March 20th, RCA Dome.
Michigan State leading on the strength of its perimeter players, in particular two guards, Chris Hill and Maurice Ager.
Two guys you can ill afford to give open looks. Here's Hill banging from the outside. He has a couple of trays, and Maurice Ager also has a couple of trays there getting that dunk. Now keep this in mind, Michigan State led the Big Ten Conference in field goal shooting with 52%. There were several games this year where they shot over 60%, including a game against Ohio State, Wayne, where they shot an incredible 73% for the game. You give them open shots, they can hurt you.
Well, I believe in 3 things: the curse of the Bambino, the curse of the Billy Goat, and certain courses for certain horses. And Maurice Ager loves this Northwestern course. Averaged 19 points against Northwestern and shot it at 90% from the arc in 2 games against the Wildcats this season.
Yeah, I believe in that too. It'd be hard to contradict that. The numbers don't lie there.
Northwestern needs a field goal here. They're down by 8. Inside of 7.5 to go, first half. Vukušić, tough shot off the window. Ager up high for the rebound. Most of Northwestern's shots have been under duress here tonight. Fast breaking Spartans, and this time it's Torbert who finishes.
terrific job of pushing the basketball and setting that up by Allen Anderson, who's had to play point guard and who's gotten much better at that position as the season has wore on.
First 10-point lead of the night. Vukušić diving into the lane. Another tough shot there. Backcamp rebound to Dončić.
You know, I said earlier that I like Vukušić because he can put the ball on the floor and create, but he's got to figure out a way to end with a far less difficult shot than the last two he's had.
Michigan State on a 14-3 run. Hashad leaves that one short, and the Spartans look to add to it. Hager in the corner, got by Vukušić. Open is Anderson for three. Timeout, Northwestern. Michigan State is raining trays on the Wildcats. Spartans are 6 of 9 of the arc.
You know, it took Michigan State a little time to get their ball handling in gear. But now they're coming down with a spread floor. They're passing the ball without the turnovers, and they're getting open shot after another. And that's why they're shooting such a high percentage right now.
And in transition, Anderson finding Torbert that time. They're finishing and they're outrunning Northwestern, and this game is getting to Michigan State's tempo in a hurry. Well, the Spartans came in here again off the layoff, and I know that Tom Izzo was worried about it, but he has a very unusual team. They usually lead this conference in rebounding. They usually lead this conference in many times in defense, or one of the top two or three. Well, they don't rebound it very well. They don't defend necessarily that well. But what they do is shoot it exceptionally well because they start four perimeter players and a very good accomplished big man inside.
They led the conference in field goal percentage, three-point field goal percentage, overall field goal percentage, and scoring.
And they've hit their last five shots from the floor, have the Spartans. Boy, does Northwestern need a field goal here, down by 13. Again, Michigan State does a great job of taking away the back cuts to Tim Young for three, short. Very few quality shot attempts for Northwestern in this first half.
Absolutely.
Michigan State, Fisk down, gonna run some offense here. Anderson at the point. Pograkis. Andreas down low against Dončić. Knocked away from behind, but Dončić guilty of the foul.
That's unfortunate. Dončić trying to make a play there, but really helping Michigan State because Andreas was about to be forced into something he is not real comfortable with, and that's a back-to-the-basket move.
It's the other thing about, you know, and really Davis is pretty comfortable face to the basket, and something that Tom Izzo was talking about with his team, he would like more of a low post presence, back to the basket type thing, in which to go inside and then deliver outside. But you have to have a threat in the post. The guy has to be able to score off a back to the basket move for the defense to respect that.
Correct.
Coming up on 5 minutes to go, first half. Andreas the screen. Anderson, Shannon Brown traveled.
Well, that time it was Northwestern that was forced to play a long stretch of defense, and they got it done. They get the turnover and now a chance to get back to within 11, possibly 10.
And they've missed 7 of their last 8 shots from the floor. Vukušić open for a moment. Hashad on the low block. No, but a foul. Boy, there's a lid over the basket all of a sudden for Northwestern in this game. But he'll get to the line. Will Muhammad a shot? Bograkis picks up his first personal foul. 6 on the team.
Team foul number 6.
Bill Carmody looking to his bench for answers. Doesn't have much of a bench. Only played 6 yesterday. Has played 6 so far tonight. Shot making good on the first. First Northwestern free throw. They do have bodies on that bench, but they're not in the rotation. One out of two for Rashad. Anderson hustling it across with Brown in the corner. The ball knocked away, picked off by Vukušić. 4.5 to go, first half. Spartans by 12. Good delivery to Duwancic, and then what do we get? Foul coming up on Michigan State. Dan Chrisman with the call at the baseline.
Number 30.
Bograkis with his second foul in as many trips.
His second foul.
That's seven on the team.
Team foul, number seven.
If Northwestern can pull itself back into this game, then you can stay with your style, with your attack, your philosophy. But if you fall too far down, Wayne, the only way you can get back in is playing Michigan State's way, and that would not be to their benefit.
Duwancic missing on his first, he'll have another. You're exactly right. Northwestern is not a great free throw shooting team at 68.3%. That was only good for eighth in the Big Ten. Duwancic, the 1.1 assist belies what a good passer he is, especially on the bounce pass to the back door. But he misses two more at the free throw line. Shannon Brown, Chris Hill, Tim Bograkis, Jason Andreas, and Alan Anderson on the floor for Michigan State. 15 to go on the shot clock for the Spartans. Down to five. The freshman against Vukušić. Step away jumper. No. Duwancic the rebound. Able to save to Rashad.
That was great defense that time by Vukušić. Staying in front and not getting beat off the dribble.
But then a wild shot by Rashad, and it'll go to Michigan State. Northwestern trailing by 12, just under 4 minutes to go.
Golf Digest is going to Cure Your Slice now and for free.
And that's a guarantee.
Introducing the breakthrough video, Cure Your Slice Now, and it's free with your paid subscription to Golf Digest magazine. In this video, top PGA instructor Chuck Cook shows you the seven key phases of the swing and gives you his proven method for better control and longer, straighter drives. And here's our guarantee. If Golf Digest and Cure Your Slice Now doesn't cure your slice and improve your game, cancel and keep the video free.
Golf Digest is your source for golf.
Every month in Golf Digest, you get easy-to-follow tips and instruction from the best teachers and players in golf. Information on the top equipment, the best places to play, thought-provoking commentary. You also get this removable Pocket Tips booklet. Call now. Use your credit card and get your first risk-free issue, Pocket Tips booklet, and video free. You get 11 more issues for only $19.77. If your game doesn't improve, cancel and keep the video, booklet, and magazine free.
So call 800-543-6200. That's 800-543-6200. Call now.
The market goes up. You make money. The market goes down. You make money. It's good to be a Barron's reader. Barron's. News before the market knows. No one looks at the market with a more insightful eye than Barron's, offering timely coverage of stocks, bonds, mutual funds, everything the independent investor needs to stay informed. Subscribe now, and you'll also receive this Barron's Stock Evaluator free. It lets your computer help you turn money into wealth. Get 13 weeks of Barron's and the Stock Evaluator, all for only $39. Call now, toll free, 800-334-6600. That's 800-334-6600.
Craig Kishon and Sean Morris back with you in Indianapolis for the Big Ten quarterfinal, the Big Ten tournament between Michigan State and Northwestern. Spartans lead this one 31-19 with 3:38 to go in the first half. Northwestern in danger of losing out in this game right now, trailing to Tim Young, Sean. 10 points early in this game, but he's been shut out since. 8 points, actually.
Michigan State doing a fantastic job, much like we saw Wisconsin do to Chris Humphreys. Michigan State has done the same thing to Jatim Young, really taking him out of the offensive flow, and as a result, Michigan State's been able to exploit that three-point shooting to extend to the lead they have right now.
We'll take a look at the action from the rest of the Big Ten quarterfinals, plus action from around the country at halftime. Wayne, Greg.
All right, thank you much, guys. We'll look forward to it. Got a violation. Hang on, got a foul coming up here off the ball on Andreas working in the post, and Tom Izzo, a dumbfounded look on his face. Andreas picks up his first, eight on the team. Offensive foul on Andreas. Northwestern seeking field goal help. Tough angle on that pass. The steal by Shannon Brown, but he ran out of real estate, stepped out of bounds. Good overplay by Brown on the post feed.
Right there showed the exact point that Sean Morris made a moment ago. Michigan State has played to Tim Young very, very well. It took him a little time to figure him out, but his touches have been very few of late.
And Greg, Northwestern's gone 5.5 minutes without a field goal. This is no time to go cold. Young spinning into the lane. No, but a foul. He'll go to the line.
It's important, and you see how important it is, you know, Tim Young, that is, to Northwestern's cause. So it is critical that they find ways to get him the basketball, even if they have to give it to him out on the perimeter and say, hey, go create some offense for yourself.
Foul was on Maurice Ager, his second, nine on the team. Tim Young at the free throw line, 8 points so far, much of that early in this game. And Northwestern struggling at the free throw line, Greg. They could ill afford to go 1-for-4 at the free throw line.
You know, they've held Michigan State to 31 points for quite some time now. But every time they come down the floor and miss a free throw, they're just not helping themselves. Tim Young finally able to get them off the free throw schneid. But when you fall behind, you can ill afford to lose those freebies.
Especially when you go 4.5, 5 minutes without a field goal.
Right.
Under 3 minutes to go, first half. Michigan State has been very impressive offensively. Andreas working hard in the post against Duwancic, and Duwancic overplays him, but then off his foot out of bounds. Good hustle, good work on the post by Davor Duwancic of Northwestern. Bill Carmody, the Big Ten Coach of the Year. His team hit its low with a loss in their final non-conference game to Mississippi Valley State, and then a blowout loss at Michigan to start Big Ten play. Hill, Anderson able to make the catch. Had a good look at it. Andreas, the offensive rebound. Hill clears. Anderson on the drive, got fouled by Tim Young. Was it Young or was it TJ Parker? They're going to call Parker on the reach. His second personal, five on the team.
You know, again, Michigan State sitting on 31 for quite some while. Why? Because Northwestern has turned it up defensively. They are scrambling out there. They're helping each other. They're rotating and recovering. So now all of a sudden, Michigan State's not getting those open looks.
Yep. Chris Hill on the trigger. Allen Anderson. Sets the floor. Good spacing now in this particular possession for Michigan State. Brown clears on the wing. Rashad jumps at him defensively. Brown jumps into the lane and one.
The mistake that Muhammad Rashad made was when he reached. He sacrificed his good defensive position right there. Now you're behind. Now you're trying to catch up, and you're not going to be able to do it against a player as good as Shannon Brown.
Rashad picks up his first personal foul. Six on the team. Shannon Brown, true freshman out of Maywood, Illinois. From Iso East, he played his first 2 years of high school in the same backcourt with D. Brown. Talk about quickness in that backcourt, huh?
Man.
Oh, man.
D. Brown has always had a great backcourt partner, huh, over the last
yeah.
few years?
You got Darren Williams now. He's not bad. Apparently, a foul here on Duwancic off the missed free throw. Brown back to the line. Makes the free throw. Not a foul, but a lane violation on Duwancic. Young. Big biggest lead of the night for Michigan State. Hashad got open on the back door, but a whistle before the shot attempt. Foul on Michigan State. Bill Carmody, the posture says it all.
You know, there are sometimes when, as a coach, you don't want a foul called. You don't want a foul called for your team. Because that time it
negated.
That's a good
point.
Yeah, it negated a field goal. And they haven't had a field goal in a long time.
How about this? They started 6-10. They're 1-9 since. Throw in a few turnovers on top of that, and you've got a loss of offensive efficiency. And you're looking at a 14-point deficit if you're Northwestern. Muhammad Hashad makes good on his first. Northwestern now just 3 of 7 of the free throw line. And a split is all she wrote. Not good enough when you're struggling from the field the way the Wildcats are in the last 10 minutes of this first half. 13-point lead for the Spartans. Shannon Brown clears again.
Shannon Brown scores. 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout asked for and taken on the floor by Michigan Northwestern. State. Shannon Brown with his second from the field.
Well, Shannon Brown is a rapidly improving freshman who is showing that he can get his own offense. There, the nice crossover on Bakusic. Gets the necessary room to get the pull-up jumper to go.
36-21 Michigan State, and this is the final quarterfinal game in the 2004 Big Ten basketball tournament. And take a look at the advances today. Illinois, impressive against Indiana. Michigan hung on against Iowa. Hawkeyes made a nice run at them. Earlier tonight in the evening session, Wisconsin basically ground out Minnesota. And Michigan State is doing more of the same to the Northwestern Wildcats. We've really seen, Greg, only one mild upset, and that would be Michigan, the fifth seed, over the number four seed, Iowa.
Now Michigan has to find a way to win perhaps one more game so that the Big Ten can get four teams. A lot of people think this way. I'm thinking that Michigan may still be in, but maybe just to certify it, they may need one more win so that the Big Ten can get four teams. They've never had less than five in the NCAA tournament since they went to 64 teams.
The given three, of course, are Illinois, Wisconsin, and Michigan State. Off the ball, got a whistle down low. I think Delco Rowley guilty of a hold inside. It is on Rowley, who just checked in for Michigan State. Greg, I think you're exactly right. You know, maybe Michigan's got to get a win tomorrow. They have to play pretty well in that ball game tomorrow against Illinois. But I think a win against Illinois would get them in. I don't think there's any way they could keep them out of the tournament.
Yeah. I don't know, and I would have to check, but I don't know that if there are that many teams that have won 18 games and not gotten in.
This is an unusual year, and of course, it's also a year that has seen some top seeds fall quickly. And talk about Southern Illinois in the Missouri Valley,
right.
St. Joe's out of the A-10. And whenever that happens, a bubble team like Michigan, that bubble grows a little smaller.
Yeah, and when I say 18 wins, I'm talking about Big Ten teams with 18 wins.
Yeah.
Usually that's good enough.
But is it good enough this season?
This year, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Coming up on a minute to go first half. Allen Anderson. Delco Rowley. Rowley's a big body inside trying to post up. Hill backs off, looks for some room. Shannon Brown with time winding down to the shot clock, down to 10. Rashid Johnson. Was it offensive? It was. Warded off Evan Seacat, who flopped nicely to draw the call.
How about Seacat? Not known for his defense, known more for his three-point shooting, but that time able to position himself properly to draw a charge.
10 turnovers in the first half for Michigan State, but they're shooting it at 68%, so it almost nullifies that negative. About a 5-second difference, shot clock to game clock. Hashad for three. Anderson the rebound. Boy, I can't remember the last time Northwestern hit a field goal. It's been a while.
And now Northwestern will question taking that shot as early as they did, Michigan State with a chance to get the last shot and build on a 13-point lead.
Hill spins away from Bukusich. Final seconds, and the first half ends with Michigan State unable to get off a shot. Maurice Ager came off the bench with 9 points and 3 of 4 shooting from the field. Northwestern's last lead was 15-14 with 10:50 left in the first half. Michigan State on a 22-8 close. Northwestern did not have a field goal in the final 8 minutes of the first half. Craig and Sean coming up on the other side of these messages.
I've been making these little thin 99-cent hamburger patties for the fast food industry all my life. I get calls every day. People ask me, hey, Jimmy, can you make a thinner, cheaper burger? A couple months ago, I got a call from a guy. He wanted this huge, big, thick patty. Now, this beats all. He wanted it made out of Angus beef, the best you can buy. Get this, the real shocker, it was Hardee's on the phone.
The new low-carb thick burger with only 5 carbs. It's how the last place you'd go for a burger will become the first.
Take care of the big stuff.
Love you, Dad.
We'll take care of the rest. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Finally, winter is almost over. Here's a great way to bring on spring. This sale ends Monday, so bring your briefcase, bring your bathing suit. Just bring on spring today.
Dodge does trucks like nobody else. During Dodge Truck Month, you can grab the 500-horsepower SRT10, the Hemi-powered Ram 1500, and the Ram heavy-duty with re-engineered Cummins 600 turbo diesel. Now with some of our best deals, like up to $3,500 cash allowance or 0% financing, plus an additional $1,000 truck month bonus on select Rams. And grab our 770 powertrain limited warranty. Powerful trucks, powerful offers, only during Dodge Truck Month.
It's halftime here from Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Michigan State leads Northwestern 36-23 in the Big Ten Tournament quarterfinal game. The winner moving on to the semis to face the Wisconsin Badgers. Hello, everybody, along with Sean Morris. Craig and Sean back with you in Indianapolis. Well, it's all about Michigan State's offense turning it on, shooting 68% from the floor.
And particularly in the early going, Craig, they were able to stretch that Northwestern matchup zone defense. Maurice Ager came in off the bench, picked up where he left off when these teams met earlier this season, knocked down some threes, as did Chris Hill. As a result, Northwestern had to come out, play some man-to-man, which is not really their comfort zone given their lack of depth. As a result, then Michigan State was able to get some dribble penetration. And then on the defensive end, the Spartans did a fantastic job of taking Tim Young out of the ballgame.
Ager leading a balanced scoring attack with 9 points so far in the first half for Michigan State. As I mentioned, the winner of this game will take on Wisconsin in tomorrow's semifinal game. Wisconsin defeated Minnesota earlier this evening.
And Wisconsin did a fantastic job of containing Chris Humphreys. Here we see a rare example of Humphreys being able to get in and finish with his strength. Wisconsin was able to take him out of the game defensively. On the offensive end of the floor for the Badgers, it was, as it has been all year, Devin Harris, fantastic. Dribble penetration, the ability to take the contact and finish, knock down some long-range threes as well. And then Mike Wilkinson led the defensive effort for Wisconsin as they were able to put away Minnesota and advance.
Wisconsin wins their fifth straight overall, 66-52. The final there, they improved to 22-6 on the season. Earlier today in quarterfinal play, Illinois advanced, winning 71-59 over Indiana, and Michigan tops Iowa 79-70. It'll be Michigan and Illinois in the first semifinal tomorrow. When we come back to Indianapolis, we will take a look at the national scene. Plenty of big tournament action. We'll have the scores in a moment.
Great devotion to a single purpose. That defines a team. Those who stumble but still find the will to rise up, risking pain for the chance to stand out from the crowd. And having tasted both victory and defeat, steadily raise expectation. The NCAA Championships on ESPN.
This much is clear. There will come a time in your life when you have to choose sides. Specifically, right after you make your steak burger, a platter. We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious. The sippable sundae.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
Doctor, I feel so guilty.
Yes, Mark?
Well, I took something. They called it a gift, but I feel like I took advantage of them.
Did you open a completely free checking account at Union Federal Bank?
Get a free gift when you open a completely free checking account from Union Federal Bank. It's practically a steal.
How did you know that, Doctor?
I'm gifted. Oh, our time is up.
Union Federal Bank. All your bank should be.
Halftime entertainment here at Conseco for the crowd. Michigan State entertaining the crowd with a 36-23 lead after the first half of basketball. This is our final quarterfinal game of the Big Ten tournament. We move along to the semifinals tomorrow, so the action heats up. There's no question about that. Well, let's take a look at the national scene now, Sean, starting in the ACC. Plenty of big tournaments going on. Duke and Virginia, take it away.
Virginia's short turnaround from the game last night against Clemson, and as a result, it was all Duke. Sheldon Williams, a career game for the Blue Devils. Here he finishes up the flush. J.J. Redick, as he's done all year, tough from behind the arc, and then Sheldon Williams, just too much inside. Virginia goes home with the loss.
84-74, the victory for Duke. They've won a record 16 straight ACC tournament games. Elsewhere, Georgia Tech and North Carolina hooked up in a nice, tight ball game that went down to the wire.
Raymond Felton, tough finish at the rim for the Tar Heels, but Georgia Tech not going anywhere. Luke Shenshear with the flush. Sean May goes to the line and puts North Carolina up 82-81, but Georgia Tech solid all year. Here it's Jarrett Jett that answers the call, able to split the defenders, knock down the jump shot. Big win for Georgia Tech.
They win it by one, 83-82. Shenshear and Jack, 17 points apiece. Jack, of course, the game winner with under 2 seconds to go. Other ACC scores, North Carolina State hangs on to possibly eliminate Florida State, 78-71, and just underway, Wake Forest, the early lead over Maryland in the ACC. Let's take a look at the bracket and how things lay out right now. Duke and Georgia Tech will meet tomorrow in the semis. North Carolina State awaits the winner of Wake Forest and Maryland. Let's go down to Dallas for the Big 12 quarterfinal. Oklahoma State and Iowa State start our action.
Oklahoma State, the regular season champ in the Big 12, and you can see why. Joey Graham throws it down, then he shows his versatility, steps out, knocks down the jump shot, then the ability to get in the lane, hits the nice little mid-range jump shot there, just inside the paint. Nice job by John Lucas right there, Craig, of creating space, but defense has really been a hallmark of this Oklahoma State program. Here's no exception. Nice job by John Lucas. Takes the hoop, the harm, and the finish.
83-75. Happy birthday to Eddie Sutton, who wins today on his 68th birthday in the Big 12 quarterfinals. Colorado and Texas Tech also in action. Colorado, a bubble team coming in, of course.
And Colorado really needed this one, Craig, and it started off very well for the Buffaloes. Blair Wilson, one of the top three-point shooters in the conference, shows you here why. Nice job of stepping behind the little rub screen, knocks down the three. But Texas Tech showing a lot of versatility. Michael Marshall, the left-hander, knocks it down. Then a good ball reversal here, hits another jump shot. And then Jarius Jackson, watch the use of the crossover right here. Gets by the defender, the ability to get in the lane and finish. That's good news for Texas Tech. They're able to get the win. The conference's leading scorer, Andre Emmett, pretty much held in check.
They win it by 10, 79-69. Let's take a look at some other Big 12 scores. Texas nearly beats Oklahoma 66-63 in that game.
Texas needed to rebound. They had a tough loss on the road to finish the regular season at Kansas State. Good job by the Longhorns of bouncing back. Oklahoma, very tough team, really wanted to keep the score low.
And in the SEC, check this out.
Vandy beats Mississippi State in overtime.
Vanderbilt has some great players, Matt Frege being one of them. I think right now, Craig, what that does with that loss by Mississippi State, it opens the door for Kentucky, if they're able to win that SEC tournament, to get a number one seed in the NCAA.
Very interesting developments going on. We're going to come back with more here from Indianapolis. First award for the Big Ten, and also Northwestern and Michigan State when we come back.
No one has won more NASCAR Cup races than Chevy, and no one offers a bigger lineup of cars and trucks. And now, check out Silverado through March 31st and leave your checkbook at home. GM employees who are qualified lessees can lease a Silverado LS four-wheel drive for $320 a month with zero due at signing. Tax, title, and license, extra residency restrictions. Buy call for important lease details. Chevy, turn the key, start a revolution. See your Central Indiana Chevy dealer today.
You make me feel so young. You make home improvements so much fun. When I see how low the payments are, I'll take the looks of my space car. Fifth Third Equity FlexLine's low monthly payment will make your space sing. 'Cause you make my space feel fun. Working hard to be the only bank you'll ever need.
Finding the right health plan can seem like you're in a real maze. So when it's time to decide, being able to choose can make all the difference. That's why with Sagamore Health Network, you get lots of choices. From more doctors to choose from, to more hospitals to choose for care. So next time, choose a health plan that's not a maze, just amazing. Sagamore Health Network, simply the better choice.
Close a great deal now with 0.9% financing or up to $2,500 cash back. On select new Nissans through March 31st at your Nissan dealer.
Northwestern University. Exceptional academic opportunities. Two beautiful lakefront campuses. Outstanding faculty. Lifelong friendships. Northwestern University in Chicago, a symphony of success.
Fans embody the spirit of college basketball.
They're on top of it right from the get-go. That's what makes it so exciting.
The fans are going wild and they're screaming and yelling.
The place erupts. That's what's very, very special about our conference.
Whatever it takes, they're going to be at the games cheering for their teams.
It's a phenomenal atmosphere every night in Big Ten basketball.
The important thing is with fans is that they let the team know that they're behind them, and I think that's what fans are for, and I think that's what sportsmanship is all about.
We have the greatest attendance in the nation. We appreciate the fans. They should be proud of that.
Root your team on, and again, be passionate, be loyal, but do it in a way that's respectful.
So do your part the next time you cheer from the stands.
Show good sportsmanship and respect the fans,
the officials,
and the great tradition that is Big Ten basketball.
Big Ten basketball. Good sports make great fans.
We're at the break in Indianapolis. The Spartans lead the Wildcats by 13. Wayne and Greg are coming back for the second half in just a moment.
Whether he's fully dressed.
Never seen you so styling.
Gotta get out more, my brother.
Partly dressed.
That's Grandma Trudy's afghan.
Or otherwise.
A guy gets in bed with you, you put some pants on.
Robert always proves the clothes don't make the man.
This was my lucky suit.
Well, I think you're down to lucky pants.
Catch all the laughs on Everybody Loves Raymond.
Weeknights at 10, Indiana's WB4.
Doctor, I feel so guilty.
Yes, Mark?
Well, I took something. They called it a gift, but I feel like I took advantage of them.
Did you open a completely free checking account at Union Federal Bank?
Get a free gift when you open a completely free checking account from Union Federal Bank. It's practically a steal.
How did you know that, Doctor?
I'm gifted. Oh, our time is up.
Union Federal Bank. All your bank should be.
My superhero plastic cup collection almost fills my room up. I mean, it's huge. I'm up to 235 cups, which includes a bunch from Hardee's. But, yeah, I've been hearing this rumor. I don't know if it's true or not, but I hear they're not going to give away collector cups anymore. Pretty lame, if you ask me. I mean, why else would anyone want to go there now?
Thick burgers and no more giveaways. Because nobody gives away anything with their burgers unless they have to.
Wayne Larrabee, Greg Kelcer, welcome back to the quarterfinals of the Big Ten Tournament in Indianapolis. And, you know, it's interesting to see how this game started. Both teams got off to very quick starts offensively, Greg, but it was apparent that Northwestern was making almost circus shots early on, and they rarely got a good, clear look at the basket.
Well, Northwestern was able to hit six of their first nine shots, getting the ball to Tim Young, and he being able to work it out down low. Since that time, just 1 of 11 shooting for Northwestern. Meanwhile, Michigan State is taking what Northwestern is allowing. They're giving them the perimeter, and Michigan State is burning them up from the outside, mostly with their guard shooting the basketball, spreading the floor, and you notice a lot of unguarded shots. That has to improve in the second half if you're Northwestern.
And here are the numbers of the first half. Again, Michigan State shot it exceptionally well. And on those 13 made field goals, they had 10 assists. Now, the turnover is a little bit high for Michigan State, but when you're shooting it at 68% from the field, you could afford a few turnovers.
You can weather it.
Northwestern did not have a field goal in the final 8 minutes and 39 seconds of the first half, but they get it going right away. Davor Dvancic inside.
If they can get that activity along with some outside shots, they'll have balance in their offensive attack, and that can get them back in the game. That is too, Wayne, if they continue with the defense that they ended the first half with. They held Michigan State intact for the last 5 or 6 minutes of the half.
That is the first Northwestern team foul. Foul on Vukušić, or I should say,
Murray Zager, number 13.
Dvancic on the foul. It is his second personal of the first on the team. The inbounds to Anderson. Stripped away by Hashan and picked up by Vukušić.
Well, the defense is there. Northwestern's commitment to defense after Michigan State got the 31 points. It's why they're still in this game, because Michigan State has not been able to hurt them very much since getting 31. Just 5 points since.
Foul committed here by Paul Davis, and a slow start to this second half for Michigan State. Davis is third, and that is the first on the team here in the second half. Michigan State held Northwestern to 23 first half points, second lowest first half output this season for Northwestern. Vukušić on the block. To the left hand, left it short. And here come the Spartans in transition. Allen Anderson to Paul Davis running the floor. Sets up Ager out of the corner for three.
If there's one guy that Northwestern should never leave open, after all, in terms of what he's done, it's Maurice Ager.
I was going to ask you, has legislation been passed that they can't guard Ager? He's been open all night.
Yep.
Maurice Ager came on off the bench in the first half, scored 9 straight Michigan State points over a 153 span, and he's at it again in the start of the second half.
I mean, he's telling them, he's showing them, you leave me open, I'm going to nail it. Every time.
You would think they'd know after the way he played against them this season. He gets a well-deserved break on the bench. Muhammad Ashad sets it up. Michigan State leading by 14. Northwestern can ill afford a slow start to the second half. Hashad measures a three. Mikusic got pushed out of the way. Parker comes up with a rebound off the floor.
He did get pushed, didn't he?
Yeah.
I mean, noticeably.
Two Spartans were pushing. They took themselves out of the play. Michigan State showing zone. Pressure on the ball, delivered by Torbert. To Tim Young. Northwestern's had a hard time, Greg, operating its offense in the half court against that zone. They're not getting the back cuts they like to get.
And that's the purpose. That's the reason why Michigan State has stayed in that zone.
And it forces outside shots, which are not a high percentage. Bill Carmody said yesterday, he said, you know, we're not a good three-point shooting team. Yes, they get more three-point field goals made per game than anyone else, but they don't shoot it at a high percentage. They're 32% from the arc, and that's 10th in the conference. 4 of 11 tonight.
Well, if you're Michigan State, you're wanting to force them to the thing they do poorest.
Yeah.
And that's the three-point shooting. That's the perimeter game. So you stay in your zone.
Davis down low. A shot. Double teams and makes the steal. Behind the back wraparound to Jatim Young. Young into traffic. Gets it right back. Blocked by Davis.
Well, good. You saw the tenacity of Young, but he had two guys to go against him that time. Paul Davis has not had an offensive impact on this game, but he has manned the middle pretty good.
Yes, he has. Yep. Young, meanwhile, 9 points early in the game and hasn't been heard from since offensively. And Chris Hill drains another triple. He's got 11. 45.6% from the arc this season for Chris Hill. Timeout, Northwestern.
And a good timeout, because this game is getting away from them, and Bill Carmody knows, hey, we are not going to come back from too far down if it gets any worse.
Meanwhile, Paul Davis making his presence felt on the defensive end, denying Jatim Young. Michigan State in the lead.
Describe the perfect day, Liz.
Well, we're driving to the lake. The kids watch a DVD, and Joe and I have some quality time.
Joe?
Okay, we're barreling along. The Hemi's kicking some serious butt. Then we fish.
Ah, see, you're not traveling in the same vehicle.
The all-new Durango. Big size, smooth ride, Hemi power.
What a quack.
The all-new Dodge Durango, starting under $26,600.
We don't doubt the billions. It's the serve part we have trouble with.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
You make me feel so young. You make home improvement so much fun. And every time I see your rates, I know I'll make my space look great. Fifth Third Equity Flex Lines low rates will make your space safe. Cause you make my space feel fun. Working hard to be the only bank you'll ever need.
Chevy Trailblazer and Chevy Trailblazer EXT. It's time to expect more from a midsize sport utility. And now through March 31st, expect to leave your checkbook at home. GM employees who are qualified lessees can lease a Trailblazer two-wheel drive LS for $272 a month with zero due at signing. Tax, title, and license extra. Residency restrictions apply. Call for lease details. Chevy Trailblazer and Trailblazer EXT. Turn the key. Start a revolution. See your Central Indiana Chevy dealer today.
Welcome back to Conseco. Big Ten Conference final quarterfinal game. Michigan State in the lead right now and in command. But let's go back to our star comparison. Two all Big Ten players in this game.
Well, we missed the boat, didn't we? We said these two guys would have a major impact offensively. It hasn't happened. Give credit to the defense of both teams. Northwestern has eliminated Paul Davis. Michigan State has forced Northwestern to have to go elsewhere. Jatim Young had a good start, hasn't been able to maintain it.
Yeah, he has really struggled since the early going of this game. Young in traffic, nearly lost it and did lose it out of bounds. One field goal for Northwestern in the last 11 minutes, almost 12 minutes of this game. They've missed 11 of 12 shots and have been plagued by turnovers at times. Michigan State is really, oh, there's a near steal by his shot, and last touch by Anderson. Anderson says, wait a minute, he touched it, I didn't touch it. Already today, Illinois, Michigan, and Wisconsin have advanced into the semifinal round, waiting for one last partner in the Final Four of the Big Ten tournament. Boy, again, Hill took away that back cut by T.J. Parker, forced the outside shot by Jatim Young.
You know, it's almost like Jatim Young, as we talked about in the earlier game with Chris Humphries, when Jatim Young takes an outside shot, he's their best offensive rebounder, so they're not getting any second opportunities off his misses.
Great point. Torber, jab steps. T.J. Parker takes him baseline. Davis, very quiet. 1-for-2 from the field in this game. 7 to go on the shot clock. Anderson hustles his team into a set. Down to 3. Davis beats the clock. Beautiful feed from Allen Anderson.
That was set up brilliantly. Michigan State spreading the floor and setting a good screen and then rolling off of that. Davis able to get a wide open shot, his second shot or second field goal of this game.
So often on this level, Greg, you see the kids, as Vukušić from the outside off the mark there. When the shot clock gets under 10, the ball starts moving and people start moving a little quicker. That time, Michigan State just continued its play.
Yep.
Didn't get into that hyper type of activity.
Yeah, right, never panicked.
Brown to Paul Davis.
And to Davis's credit in this game, he didn't force anything.
That's exactly right.
Most guys, when they're used to scoring, and if they can't get the basketball or get shots, they start throwing up anything that they touch.
Shannon Brown off the window. Davis, the offensive rebound, and they reload the offense for Michigan State. The winner here gets Wisconsin. Hill to Davis. Dewančić overplaying from behind is called for the foul. His third personal, second on the team here in the second half.
Officials giving both teams a warning right now. It's getting a little chippy inside. They want to clean it up right now.
Moments ago with the shot clock winding down. No panic. Anderson on the feed. Davis to beat the clock and the Wildcats. 44-25. Michigan State into the lead.
It's easy to burn off a refreshing low-carb rock green light. This workout is called After You. Feel the burn. Now you've got the green light.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Susan. I'm Frank's friend, Steve.
Of course you are.
Nice to meet you.
Come on in. Dinner's almost ready.
Oh, I thought we were going out. I made reservations.
Oh, no. I made lasagna. Oh, don't worry. I used soy cheese because I know that you're lactose intolerant.
Okay.
Oh, gosh. Try this on.
Wow, you made this for me?
Yeah, I learned how to knit online. It's really no big deal. And these. And this. Okay. Let's go meet my parents.
Special treatment. Bad idea for blind dates? Good idea for online trading. Ameritrade Apex is our premier active trading program. Get special benefits like the latest trading tools, access to exclusive webcasts, and discounts on research products.
Hi, Steve.
Sign up now and get $100 if you qualify for Apex, plus 25 commission-free internet equity trades. Go to Ameritrade.com/Apex/ or call 866-368-4610.
Get in the zone.
I'm Jesse James. When it comes to my cars, I'm all business. I keep them tuned up and looking sharp. When something breaks, I fix it. When I need a part, I trust the pros at AutoZone. When you want to get serious about your car, get in the zone. AutoZone.
It's easy to burn off a refreshing low-carb rock green light. This workout is called After You. Feel the burn. Now you've got the green light.
wonderful Conseco Fieldhouse, downtown Indianapolis, Indiana. Big Ten quarterfinals not going well for Willie the Wildcat. Tom Izzo makes his points, but his players have really been the people somersaulting into the lead. It has been Maurice Ager off the bench who's played a big role in the Spartans' rock along. Leading 45-25. Northwestern has hit its first field goal attempt of the second half, 0-for-7 since. One field goal for Northwestern as Davis gets pushed there in the last 14 minutes of the game. Take a look at the storyline. Luther Head, a career-high 29 points when he plays well to supplement the scoring of the two guards for Illinois. It makes Illinois a much better team. I mean, they go to the next level.
How about Luther Head exceeding his career high by 10 points?
Unbelievable.
He never scored over 20.
He's a young man who overcame a lot of off-court problems this year. Involving, and again, his doing, and he owned up to it. But the last couple of weeks, he's helped put Illinois on another level from an offensive standpoint. Still 44-25. Michigan State. C-Cat in the ball game. They'd like to get a triple out of him somewhere along the line. They'd like to get a triple out of anybody. Tim Young beat Maurice Ager to the baseline that time, and Ager commits the foul. His third, second on the team.
Maurice Ager, his third personal foul. Second,
you gotta wonder again, Northwestern with that very short bench. Remember early on, I mentioned three of their starters played 40 minutes in that ball game yesterday.
It's also worth pointing out how important this game is to Northwestern in terms of extending their season.
They will go to no tournament, not the NCAA, not the NIT, if they lose here tonight. You must have at least a 500 record overall to qualify for a postseason tournament.
You know what, Wayne, and they knew it long before they got here.
Yep.
That's why they felt that it was critical that they win their last home game against Michigan. They let that game get away. That forced them to have to come here and win two games at least.
Yep. A crucial loss to Michigan at home, as you mentioned. Bill Carmody's been hit with a technical foul.
That is also charged as a team foul.
And of course, that is a team foul
against the Wildcats.
Four team fouls against the Wildcats. And they'll shoot the technical foul as there's the Big Ten Coach of the Year. It's been a frustrating night for him against this Michigan State team. Third time these two teams have played. Michigan State won the first game 73-61 in Evanston January 21st. And Michigan State scored 66-56 February 21st in East Lansing. Hill makes good on the free throw. He's got another. Northwestern, one field goal to start the second half. 6 minutes, almost 6 minutes gone by in the second half.
Chris Hill, recently named Academic All-America.
First-team Academic All-America.
First team, yep, as
a
junior.
Do you remember the last first-team Academic All-America in Michigan State history?
Not as a junior.
How about that? Greg Kelser was the last Spartan to earn that first team honor.
Took me 4 years, though. Chris beat it by a whole year. He's done it right.
Absolutely. Yeah, we're proud of you, Special K. Was honored earlier this year with the Ring of Honor Award, special award by the NCAA for contributions in your career, in your community. After 25 years after your playing career. Hard to believe it's been that long.
Well, it also says I'm getting up there, huh?
Yep. You're joining the rest of us in a hurry. Young inside tried to jackknife that one in. Foul coming up on Michigan State.
Kelvin Torbert, number 23.
Kelvin Torbert, third personal on him.
Third team foul.
We'll send you Tim Young to the line. First team all Big Ten has started every game of his collegiate career, and this might be his last game here tonight unless this thing turns around. Tom with the little body language there to the officials, say, hey, wait a minute, we didn't body him bad. Or One out of two at the line for Jatim Young.
You know, Northwestern is a cautious type team. In other words, you know, they play long possessions, but to get back into this game, they have to abandon that theory and start getting on some shots early. Some three-pointers, just something to get something going in this game, because their attack right now out of the half court is not working against this Michigan State defense.
Tough shot there for Paul Davis. Davis now with 6 points. Michigan State in command, but Seacamp delivers a triple.
See, that's what I'm talking about right there. They didn't worry about the shot clock and working it down. Seacamp had the ball, he went right up with it. They may have to do more of that.
Torbert looking to answer. There's a young man who really, over the course of his career at Michigan State, has improved his shooting tremendously.
Like right now, in transition, if you can get something quick, open, go for it. Because if you're going to set up the entire game the rest of the way, it might not get you a victory.
You're down by 19, and you have less than 13 minutes to go in the game. Michigan State might help them out with a foul or two, and that's what they appear to be doing right now. But Northwestern hasn't been automatic with the free throw line either. It's 6 of 12. Foul is on Maurice Ager, and it is his fourth personal foul.
Winner of this game, of course, gets Wisconsin, and I would imagine for Michigan State, they probably welcome that opportunity.
Absolutely. After losing at home on the final regular season game of Michigan State's campaign, they lost to Wisconsin in an overtime battle. And that game, that loss, denied Michigan State its share of the Big Ten title. Illinois eventually won the title outright with a victory at Ohio State last Sunday.
Not a lot of movement right now from Northwestern.
Young for three. Boy, the block out by Davis allowed that rebound to carry him to the floor. And here's Anderson.
That's when you know you've done a solid job.
Absolutely.
Everybody blocking out when it can get to the floor.
Thumbs down on the set for Michigan State. And that's a lob to Anderson.
Wow, Torbert. Seacat caught napping there.
10 for Allen Anderson. 21-point lead, Michigan State. Jatim Young, and I think we had a reach on Anderson there. It is his first personal foul, fifth on the team. Just under 12 minutes left to go in this one. Michigan State in command in spectacular fashion. Torbert to Anderson for the flush.
The following is performed by trained professionals. Do not try this at home. You'll laugh. You'll cringe. You'll wonder how they get insurance. You'll laugh till it hurts. Them, the 5 o'clock funnies on Indiana's WB4.
Wow, that hurts.
Other burgers are circular or rectangular. But the steak burger is spatular. Till people give you their order, I can't cook their order to order.
Right. People order, then I order you to cook the order to order.
In that order.
Exactly.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious. The sippable sundae.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents. Take care of the big stuff.
Love you, Dad.
We'll take care of the rest. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
It's what you've been waiting for. The One Ford Sales event is here. With a deal you need on Ford Ranger, $189 a month, 0% APR, or $2,500 cash back. This is on the one with incredible fuel mileage. The one that's been number one for 17 straight years. This is the One Ford Sales event you don't want to miss. $189 a month, 0% APR, or $2,500 cash back on Ford Ranger. On now at your Indiana Ford store.
Welcome back. Michigan State on top of Northwestern. Show me the perfect lob.
I'll do that, Wayne. And you know, the perfect lob involves more than just the pass and the catch, as we'll demonstrate later. But here you're going to see Allen Anderson pass off to Kelvin Torbert. And the weak side will clear, and Torbert lobs it up there beautifully for Allen Anderson, who beats C-Cat. But to make it perfect, you got to have other things happening, like that little brush right there. Davis getting a piece of Allen Anderson's man, Evan C-Cat, which opened up that lob.
To Tim Young in traffic, off the heel of the rim, but a foul coming up. And I thought the perfect lob was done with a 60-degree wedge. I had, you know, you learn something every day sitting next to you.
Hey, another month and we can do that stuff.
Paul Davis picks up his fourth personal foul. Six on the team. To Tim Young back at the free throw line.
My 60-degree wedge gets me in more trouble than most.
Yeah. You and me both. Andreas comes in. Davis leaves. Not a big offensive night, as we pointed out. Just 6 points so far. But a lot of the little things. A couple of block shots, a steal. Young makes the second.
Northwestern going to come with a little full court pressure here just to try to see if you can force Michigan State into some errors, because you're going to need some help from Michigan State if you're going to get back in this game. You're going to need them to turn it over a little bit.
20-point lead for the Spartans. Obrakis on the wing. Here's Chris Hill. Hill able to clear. Good shot up high for the rebound for Northwestern.
Chris Hill is such a good shooter, especially when he's open. I expect it to go in every single time.
Vukušić for three. Knocked out of bounds. Tolic in the lineup for the first time tonight for Northwestern. He started on occasion this season. Wanchich back on, and Tolic leaves. Short minutes for him. Or I should say seconds. Vukušić off the inbounds for three. It's one of his favorite spots on the floor. It's his first field goal since early in the first half. He had seven quick points and then was rarely heard from after that. The lead is 17 for Michigan State. Northwestern playing to keep its season alive, literally. Not just in this tournament. Bogracis missing from the outside. Northwestern is 14-14 overall. They lose here tonight and they are not eligible for postseason play in any tournament. Heel to the rim on a quick shot there by Parker. Chris Hill against Vukušić.
Nice job of protecting the basketball by Chris Hill that time. Vukušić, not a shot blocker.
Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Anderson, who denied the post feed to Vukušić.
Here again, Northwestern getting caught with both of their guards too deep. So a runout opportunity for Michigan State and a transition there. Chris Hill protecting and scoring.
To Tim Young inside and one.
They knew it was coming. They saw it coming and they just couldn't stop it.
But did you hear him saying, it's here right now, throw it, throw it. He wanted the basketball. This is one guy that can finish in traffic, even though oftentimes he gives up size. Yesterday, Penn State guarded him with 7 foot Jan Jagla, and it was a mismatch.
Oh, gosh.
It was a mismatch favor, Jatim Young.
First field goal for Jatim Young since 14:58 left to go in the first half. In the first half. Wow. I don't think I've ever seen him not score a field goal in that long a period of time on the floor. And it's not like he spent any time on the bench.
Right.
To Tim reaching in here on Matt Trannan, knocked the ball away and got called for the foul. His second personal. five on the team. The Northwestern Wildcats came to this tournament, Greg, as you mentioned a moment ago, needing to win two, and they won yesterday, but they still have to win here tonight just to be eligible for postseason play.
You know, when you come this close, you can't help but go back over that schedule and you say, hey, how did we lose this one? How did we lose that one?
Here's the steal by Hashad, recaptured by Hill. Hill backs Hashad. 9.5 to go for the game. Michigan State by 17.
Good defense by Northwestern.
Torbert, there it is.
Unfortunately, unable to seal the deal. Torbert getting the outside shot late on the shot clock.
Torbert's first field goal of the second half. He has 6 points in the game. Again, the lead is 19. Young against Torbert, a solid defensive player. Good athlete. Young struggled as he made his move into the lane. They're going to call a foul. It looked like to me Young slipped on his own, but the foul is on Kelvin Torbert, and it's his fourth.
Kelvin Torbert saying, hey, what else can I do? He's moving his feet, and there's the slip by... Yeah, that was good defense that time. I think that Jatim Young got a break there.
Shooting two.
Jatim Young at the free throw line. Now 4 of 8 from the foul line. Northwestern has not shot it very well. Just 8 of 16 free throws here tonight. How about this, Greg? Every single game of his college career. Kevin O'Neill was talking about this kid 2 years before he got to Northwestern. Out of Gordon Tech in Chicago. One of a quality individual and just all heart, Jatim Young.
Northwestern happy to have him. Michigan State nearly had him. Jatim Young wanting to go to Michigan State, but because of a sick relative, grandmother who raised him, decided to stay close to home. So that was to Northwestern's benefit. You know, his favorite player growing up was Mateen Cleaves of the Spartans.
Third personal foul on a shot, 6 on the team now. Well, Jatim Young, his career will come to a close here in Indianapolis tonight, but what a career it was at Northwestern. And he would have been an Izzo type of player. Oh, I mean, there is no question about that. He would have fit the demo there. Good shot by Shannon Brown. His first field goal of the second half. He's got 9.
I'm told there were tears at Welsh Ryan on senior day.
Oh, yeah.
When he signed off.
Hashad. Trannan the rebound. Matt Trannan is a pretty good-looking wide receiver. 6'6 and 230.
Big.
If he turns a 40 and anything less than 4'4, he's first-round draft choice for sure in a few years in the NFL. But he's also an accomplished basketball player, as we've seen this season. Shannon Brown gets an open look off a screen. Harker kept it alive. Spartans all over it in the person of Tim Bogracus. And they reload the offense. Inside of 8 minutes to go in the final quarterfinal game of this 2004 Big Ten basketball tournament. Anderson. Trannan inside of Vukušić for the rebound, and the foul by Vedran Vukušić is his third, 7 on the team.
Now charge to number 11, Vedran Vukušić.
So Matt Trannan will head to the free throw line.
The unfortunate thing for Northwestern right now, they have to be aggressive on defense. They got to gamble, take chances, try to force turnovers, but because they're over the limit, every time they foul, Michigan State walks to the free throw line to shoot free throws. So it really hampers your comeback effort.
Trannan named the top prep athlete in the nation by Prep Spotlight magazine for his exploits both as a football player and a basketball player. He's at Michigan State on a football scholarship. Fouled by Tim Bogracus here. It is his third personal foul. There's Matt Trannan. I bet you he'd be a good blocker downfield, a wide receiver. He caught 28 passes for John L. Smith's Spartans this fall.
Yeah, but you want 6'8", 230 coming at you?
No. Not if I'm a 5'10 cornerback. Sure don't. 15 for Jatim Young. Back into the game. Ager and Davis both with four personal fouls. Andreas and Bograkis head to the bench. So the Spartans will move on in this tournament unless something happens dramatically in the final 7:38. In and out on the second. 15 for Jatim Young. All he's been able to do is split his free throws here tonight. Michigan State, 17 assists on 21 field goals here tonight. Shannon Brown, open look. Northwestern, obviously, having to gamble, and some of that is by design. Their guards are very quick, and that's how they get a lot of their steals. But by the same token, when you gamble and you miss, you're going to give an open look like that one for sure.
Right.
Brown.
And notice that Tom Izzo is running a lot of plays for Shannon Brown now. To be sure, Tom Izzo is looking already ahead to tomorrow and Wisconsin and people that he's going to need to play well in that game. Shannon Brown has to be one of them.
No quit in Jatim Young. Ring it up for three. 18 for him. Just under 7 minutes to go in the game. Spartans by 18. Northwestern went on a prolonged cold streak down the stretch in the first half. No field goals in the last 8:36 of the first half, and that pretty much turned this game around. Parker on the drive. Goaltending is Trannon. Judges, he's got some hops, too.
Goaltending is gone.
Score the field goal.
Trannon can't believe it. Nearly got it.
Watch it again. T.J. Parker off the window. Trannon wipes it away, but score it for Northwestern anyway.
I'm driving up to the game tonight to give away a free can of refreshing 7-Up and $1 million for anyone who can slam dunk on our 7-Up hoop.
Back in 1927, we pumped our first gallon of Phillips 66, and word got around we made pretty good gasoline. Our idea was, treat customers like neighbors, because they are, and make sure that Phillips 66 gasoline is always good enough to keep their cars coming back week after week. It was a good idea 75 years ago, and you know what? It still is. Year after year, mile after mile, and for all the miles to come, Phillips 66.
Do you have the right truck? The best-selling half-ton regular and extended cab is now available as a crew cab. Introducing the new Silverado half-ton crew. It's the right truck from Chevy.
There's no other way to say it. When you have IRS tax debt, it's really scary. Whether it's a first notice about back taxes or you're already into liens, levies, and garnishments, you need the experts at the Seidemann Law Firm. Call for a free consultation. The Seidemann Law Firm is amazingly successful, reaching settlements in over 98% of their cases. Call today and find out if they can settle your case with the IRS for just pennies on the dollar. There's no other way to say it. Don't be scared. Be smart. Call today.
Welcome back. Downtown Indianapolis, the seat of government of the state of Indiana, the State House. And we are a number of blocks away, but not too far away, in beautiful Conseco Fieldhouse. Northwestern Michigan State, along with Greg Kelser, I'm Wayne Larrabee, Craig Kishon, Sean Morris, bringing us on the air, bridging halftime to the second half and into the from game one to game two here tonight. Doing a fine job as the studio moves to courtside. Great to have you with us tonight for this ESPN Plus doubleheader. Michigan State has commanded this game since about midway through the first half. Anderson losing his footing. They didn't get it across in time anyway. Ager finally does. Oh, my goodness. That was a long 10 count.
Hey, Northwestern turning up the heat a little bit there.
Do they have one last salvo in them? Brown, the pass to Tedford Davis, denied by Victor Scott. Here's Young.
Couple three-pointers, and you'll have some nerves in the green and white right now.
Vince Scott in the game for the first time tonight. Seacant trying to split defenders, gets held on the play. And the game summary. Michigan State has shot it over 60% all night. They dominated on the boards like they used to back in the day. Typical Tom Izzo teams. And they've gotten out of the transition as well. Matt Trannan picked up that foul. It's his first. 9 team fouls on Michigan State. Make that the 10th team foul on the Spartans, and Artie McDonald making sure the scorer's table, and he's going to allow Shannon Brown to come in for Chris Hill.
Evan Seacat at the free throw line.
I beg your pardon.
With two shots.
Brown has to stay in until this free throw, and then Hill will come into the ball game. Now Hill can come on, and Brown heads out. Brown had already gone to the bench, and Hill was in, but the officials had not officially allowed the substitution, so they take care of the bookkeeping, and now we're ready to go. Second free throw for Seacat.
15 looks insurmountable. Tom Izzo knows with the threat of the three-pointer, it is not. And Northwestern still coming with the defense. Michigan State still with some work to do to close this thing out.
And then violation by Michigan State as he stepped over the line, did Anderson. 16 turnovers by the Spartans. They give it right back to the Wildcats. And a push here by Matt Trannan.
We said that in order for Northwestern to get back, they would need some assistance from Michigan State. Well, you know what?
There's some assistance. Yeah.
Michigan State making errors.
Kucic goes to the line. Greg, I want to ask you, Michigan State playing on about a 21-point lead, their largest lead of the evening at that a few minutes ago. Do you lose your concentration out there as an athlete, an individual athlete?
One of the toughest things to do is to keep intensity when you've got a big lead. The normal thing is to relax and feel like, okay, we're cruising. The moment you do that, though, your opponent seizes the opportunity to get back in it.
But Northwestern is not shooting it nearly well enough at the free throw line to take advantage of these fouls.
You know what? If they were, they wouldn't be down nearly this much. I mean, this would be a 7-point game, 6-point game if Northwestern were knocking down free throws.
Greg, they're 11 of 22 from the line. And finally, that one drops for Kucic.
11 missed free throws, and you're trailing by 13. Hey, could have been a different game.
Could have been a much different game. Again, the pressure in the backcourt. Northwestern on an 8-0 run. Which, when it was a 21-point Michigan State lead, 8-0 is a drop in the bucket.
Yep.
But things have tightened a little bit here. State trying to go through a long possession offensively here now as we are under 6 minutes to go. Davis being fronted that time by T.J. Parker. Ager jumps into the lane and gets fouled. Foul is on to Kucic. His fourth.
Number 11, Maitland Bakusin.
18 fouls on the Wildcats. And Ager at the free throw line. Michigan State has been there just 10 free throw attempts. They made six. Ager drops the first. 13 for him. He had 24 in the first game between these two schools. He had 15 in the next. And here tonight, he's got 14. Michigan State leading it by 15. Tim Young goes to work against Kelvin Torbert. Help from Davis. Kucic in the corner. Pulls up on Davis. Tough shot. 15 for Vedran Kucic, who's starting to come alive down the stretch of the second half.
Hey, Northwestern smelling a chance.
Hill to Davis for flush.
And of course, when you're scrambling and you're trying to gamble, you're going to be prone to having that happen.
If you don't trigger it loose in the backcourt, or very close to it as Tim Young scores, you're probably going to get beat at the back line.
Yep.
20 for Tim Young in what might be his final college game. I said might be. Torbert out of the backcourt sets up Davis for a chip shot off the baseline. And four straight points by Paul Davis. He's up to double digits with 10.
He's taking his time getting there. He hasn't forced anything. And man, he has a soft touch from outside.
He sure does. Young is held on that drive by Torbert.
Here's Michigan State attacking pressure. Just what you should do in a situation like this, looking to score. Beautiful bounce pass to Paul Davis.
Kelvin Torbert, number 20.
And there it is. And then moments ago, he shows you the touch Greg talked about just off the baseline.
You know you got soft touch when the ball nestles up there like that. It stays in.
Paul Davis, four straight points for Michigan State. Meanwhile, Kelvin Torbert leaves the ball game, finishes with 6 points, fouls out with 4:34 to go. But he's the guy who really has been assigned primarily to Tim Young, and it's been a great battle.
He's had his hands full with Tim Young, but who hasn't?
Hey, hey.
Young now with 21 points. You know, you heard the ball bounce off the rim, and Tom Izzo earlier today was talking about how, why in these NBA arenas are the rims so tight? Is that just a figment of a coach's imagination or not?
I hadn't realized that. Spartans must have had a tough shoot around.
He must not have liked what he saw the shoot around. 4.5 to go, but his Spartans have shot it well here tonight. 65%. Four players in double figures. Balanced scoring for this Michigan State offense. Hill, with 8 to go on the shot clock, steps away from Dewancic. Good block on that rebound. Again, it comes off the floor to Tim Young. Young knows he has to go in a hurry. Parker on the drive. TJ with 7.
It's a four-possession game.
Michigan State's 21-point lead down to 12. Under 4 minutes to go.
Northwestern's chance here is to play without the foul and try to secure a defensive rebound if we can force a miss.
Allen Anderson. Andreas on the post now. Again, it's back to Anderson. 7 to go on the shot clock. Not a bad thing for Michigan State. Bogracki to beat the clock. Not bad at all when you finish it that way. Long possession.
Get everything you want there. Take the time off and score. Can be very demoralizing to a team that's trying to fight back.
Young for 3. Brack hits the rebound, and that may do it. We're at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, Indiana. Quarterfinals Big Ten basketball tournament, Northwestern and Michigan State. Along with Greg Kelser, Craig Kishon, Sean Morris, I'm Wayne Larrabee. Nice to have you with us, wherever you're looking in, on Big Ten basketball tonight. Under 3 minutes to go in this one. Michigan State looking to advance to the semifinals against Wisconsin. Anderson with 2 to go on the shot clock. Here's Hill for 3. Oh my. That one hit the top of the backboard and the shot clock.
Chris is going to hear about that in practice tomorrow.
He's going to hear about it from his teammates now.
You make me feel so young. You make home improvements so much fun. When I see how low the payments are, I'll take the looks of my space bar. Fifth Third Equity Flex Lines low monthly payment will make your space sing. 'Cause you make my space feel fun. Working hard to be the only bank you'll ever need.
Donato's presents Hot Chicks on Tay. These chicks are too hot for TV. They're so hot, they've inspired a spicy new pizza.
Introducing Donato's new Buffalo Chicken Pizza. It's a spicy buffalo sauce loaded edge to edge with crispy popcorn chicken, fresh veggies, and a hot sauce finish. It's the spicy buffalo taste you crave. Donato's new Buffalo Chicken Pizza.
Order now and you too can have hot chicks.
Dodge does trucks like nobody else. During Dodge Truck Month, you can grab the 500 horsepower SRT10, the Hemi-powered Ram 1500, and the Ram Heavy Duty with re-engineered Cummins 600 Turbo Diesel. Now with some of our best deals, like up to $3,500 cash allowance or 0% financing, plus an additional $1,000 Truck Month bonus on select Rams. And grab our 770 Powertrain Limited Warranty. Powerful trucks, powerful offers. Only during Dodge Truck Month. Hit it!
Finding the right health plan can seem like you're in a real maze. So when it's time to decide, being able to choose can make all the difference. That's why with Sagamore Health Network, you get lots of choices. From more doctors to choose from, to more hospitals to choose for care. So next time, choose a health plan that's not a maze, just amazing. Sagamore Health Network, simply the better choice.
This ESPN Plus game is brought to you by Rolling Rock. Rock Green Light, a low-carb premium light lager with only 2.4 grams of carbs. Back inside Conseco Fieldhouse, Sparty's going to stay the night and get ready for tomorrow. If this lead holds up for Michigan State, 66-52, but the Wildcats have shown no quit whatsoever. Michigan State's put four in double figures. A 22-8 run by Michigan State to close out the first half gave them a 13-point lead at the half. Northwestern in desperate straits. They can't wait for a good shot. They've got to get a shot. Steal by Jatim Young. In on Ager. Ager spoiled the shot but committed the foul. Ager picks up his fifth. Here's a look at the bracket set up, Greg.
And tomorrow's game, should this score hold up, you'll have Michigan State going against Wisconsin. You know, Wayne, there's a little interesting history between Wisconsin and Michigan State. Think back to 2000, the last year that Michigan State and Wisconsin were at the Final Four. Well, Michigan State beat Wisconsin four times that year, twice in the regular season, once here in this tournament, and once in the Final Four.
Everybody talks about how hard it is to beat a team three times. How about four times?
But check this out. Wisconsin now has beaten Michigan State the last four times they've met, including beating them in East Lansing to snap a 53-game home winning streak, and then beating them in East Lansing again to deny them a big
crown. I don't know if the folks, though, in Wisconsin would say it's even, Steven.
No.
You lose that game in the Final Four, as Wisconsin did to Michigan State, for the fourth time those two teams met that year. But at any rate, it has become a great rivalry on the basketball floor.
It makes tomorrow's game very interesting.
In the other matchup, of course, we'll have Michigan and Illinois, two very athletic teams. 2 minutes to go. This is a 14-point ball game, and we've got bodies all over the floor. Northwestern tonight needs to look no further than the free throw line. They have missed 14 free throws in this game here tonight.
That was their undoing. Part of it, anyway.
Part of it, yep. They went cold from the field, and if you're going to go long stretches without field goals, and they went over 8 minutes without a field goal late in the first half, you better be making free throws whenever you get there, and they've gotten there enough times. Pressure in the backcourt. Inbounds to Anderson. Jenkins in the ball game now. Michael Jenkins for Northwestern, and he commits the foul here. A minute 55 to go. This Bill Carmody, he's got a dry sense of humor. He's a wonderful coach and nice personality added to this conference, as well as a great coach and Big Ten Coach of the Year, well deserved this season, the way he resurrected that Northwestern team. After that loss to Michigan, we saw them the next game at Iowa. They turned their season completely around. But not enough to make a postseason tournament. Jenkins trying to feed C-Cat inside. Young for three. Sixth leading scorer all time in Northwestern basketball history. 24 for Jatim Young.
He's going out with a bang, personally.
He already fouled out Kelvin Torbert, a pretty good defensive player. Michigan State long possessions down the stretch here in the second half, and why not to seal this one away? This is the best shooting team in the Big Ten, the Michigan State Spartans. Brown with a tough shot there as Dewanchich was all over him. Ball loose on the floor, and a foul coming up. Young, Andreas was on the floor, and Bo Gracchus all going after it. I don't think these kids read the scoreboard and know how much time is left in the game. They just play as hard as they can all the way through.
It's the way it's supposed to be done.
That's what they were taught to do, yep.
Of course, if you're Michigan State, you're hoping to get out of it without any injuries. Because you're hoping you've got two more games to go.
Bo Gracchus on the steal from Jatim Young. And Brown comes up with it. Under a minute to go. Michigan State will move on. 18-10 overall. And they'll get a third shot at Wisconsin. In the semifinals tomorrow here at Conseco. About a 4-second difference, shot clock to game clock. Hill on the drive.
Basketball, Alan Anderson.
That Anderson on the drive. 12 for him. And a traveling violation. Well,
no,
10.2 remaining.
Yeah, not a timeout where you're going to have the guys come over to the bench, going to keep it rolling after these substitutions.
Going to make some substitutions here, yeah. That's what Donnie Gray was saying. He was making the traveling signal, but he meant just keep it moving. We're not going to break.
I'm going to get Jatim out of the game. Get a hand, well-deserved.
Jatim Young.
This is tough, you know that.
117 games.
Yep.
Started every game. He suited up for Northwestern. And it comes to a close. Tom Izzo, shake of the head, clasp of the hand. Bill Carmody, a hard-fought victory, but Michigan State much the better tonight. Jatim Young in his final collegiate game, 24 points, but Michigan State shoots 62% from the field, Greg.
Well, it sets up again a beautiful matchup tomorrow, Wisconsin and Michigan State. And then in that other game, you've got Illinois and a very, very athletic, surging Michigan team playing for its postseason hopes.
All right, so the quarterfinals are completed. The semifinals are set to go. Jatim Young's final collegiate game for Northwestern, and what a tremendous performer he's been. All the best to him. We're beautiful Conseco Fieldhouse. Yes, the rivalries are on here this afternoon and this evening, and we saw the conference player of the year and an all Big Ten performer. Devin Harris was as good as it gets, and so was Mike Wilkinson for Wisconsin. Jatim Young had to work hard for everything he got. And he didn't let Tom Izzo and the Spartans off easy. They win it easily, 68-55. This has been a presentation of ESPN Plus, the worldwide leader in collegiate sports television. Good night from Indianapolis.
This much is clear. There will come a time in your life when you have to choose sides. Specifically, right after you make your steak burger a platter.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious. The sippable sundae.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
Chevy Impala, a responsive performer that never forgets it's a mid-size sedan. And now through March 31st, don't forget you can still leave your checkbook at home. GM employees who are qualified lessees can lease an Impala sedan for $199 a month with zero due at signing. Tax, title, and license extra, residency restrictions apply. Call for important lease details. Chevy Impala. Turn the key. Start a revolution. See your Central Indiana Chevy dealer today.
You make me feel so young. You make home improvement so much fun. And every time I see your race, I know.
free flex lines, low rates will make your space sing. 'Cause you make my space feel fun. Working hard to be the only bank you'll ever need.
There's a time in every guy's life when he's finally out on his own. It's a time of experimentation, of trial and error. Mostly error. Cinnamon and raisin biscuits are back at Hardee's. Without us, some guys would starve.
Trading Places, Saturday at 4, Indiana's WB4.
Did you hear Howie Simon's son saw one of those funny little anecdotes to the Reader's Digest?
Yeah. Okay, good. Good for him.
That's $50.
Yeah?
So why can't you do something like that?
Dad, I'm a writer, Dad. The newspaper pays me to write full time.
Look, I'm not talking about the sports column. That's great. I'm talking on the side.
Funny anecdotes on the side.
Yeah. That's free money for you.
Okay.
Yeah. Lamb chops.
Oh, Ma, I got the dinner. She's cooking. All right, one. Hi, I'm Ray, and I live here in Long Island with my wife, Deborah. She's great with the kids, the house, everything. Oh, I don't know how she does it. We've got a daughter, Allie, and twin 2-year-old boys. It's not really about the kids. My parents live across the street. That's right. And my brother lives with them. Now, not every family would go buy on a conveyor belt for you, but mine would, because...
Everybody loves Raymond.
Yeah.
Put that flipper down. Everybody Loves Raymond will be right back.
Difference. That's why with Sagamore Health Network, you get lots of choices. From more doctors to choose from, to more hospitals to choose for care. So next time, choose a health plan that's not a maze, just amazing. Sagamore Health Network, simply the better choice.
It's world-class racing with the world's hottest moto athletes. THQ World Supercross GP. Credit seats are just $10. To see prodigy James Stewart race for the first time ever in the RCA Dome. Just $10. For superstars Reed, Wyndham, hometown hero LaRocco, and more. Just $10. For adrenaline-pumping racing. 1-800-SAFE-AUTO brings you THQ AMA Supercross Series. Brought to you by Subway, Eat Fresh, and Max Pitts Yamo in Peru. March 20th, RCA Dome.
I think I'll go for a walk outside now. The summer sun's calling my name. I just can't stay inside all day. I gotta get out and get me some of those rays. Everybody's smiling. Everybody's laughing. Everybody seems so happy today. It's a sunshine day.
Dream a little bigger with Lucky Numbers, the new $5 big money scratch off with over 10 million in prizes.
It's a sunshine day.
This much is clear. There will come a time in your life when you have to choose sides.
Specifically, right after you make your steak burger, a platter.
We had the real milk milkshakes. We had the hot fudge. Looking back, it was so obvious. The sippable sundae.
Steak and Shake. Add hot fudge to any milkshake for 39 cents.
With our score, Illinois 30 and Purdue 30, let's hear from these two fine institutions in the Big Ten Conference.
Is that one you've already tried?
The Purdue Cancer Center just celebrated 25 years of fighting cancer through basic research. The center works to identify new molecular targets and design future agents and drugs for detecting and treating cancer.
We have chemists who work on designing and synthesizing molecules for cancer diagnosis and treatment. We have a group of biologists who study proteins and study the cells and try to help us define new targets for therapy. And then finally, we have a world-renowned structure group that helps us to understand the details so that the drug design people can do a better job of coming up with new agents.
I'm trying to express it in both mammalian cells and in yeast.
One promising area involves developing miniature nanotechnology devices to help in the fight against cancer.
What we're trying to do is understand some of the molecular targets that are involved in cancer, either in preventing effective treatment or in proteins that actually cause cancer. So what we're trying to develop is basically a chip technology that instead of having 90